And here are some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of ExxonMobil and Pioneer Natural Resources. That's on news. ExxonMobil has agreed to buy its rival Shell Driller for $59.5 billion in an all-stock deal. The deal is expected to close in the first half of 2024. Pioneer stock surged more than 2% in pre-market trading, while ExxonMobil is down 1.3%. Also in focus, luxury stocks, as we reported a few moments ago. Industry bellwether LVMH reported slower third-quarter sales growth as the post-pandemic revenge spending fizzled. LVMH shares have tumbled around 6% in midday trade. We're also keeping a close watch on shares of dialysis service providers DaVita and its German rival Fresenius Medical Care. That's after Novo Nordisk's Ozempic drug showed early success in a trial to treat kidney failure in diabetes patients. Fresenius Medical Care shares are down nearly 17% in normal trading hours, while DaVita shares are plunging 16% in pre-market. Asian markets ended Wednesday trade mostly higher as investors scaled back bets of a Fed hike and cheered possible stimulus from China. South Korea's Kospi Index led the rally, jumping nearly 2%. Among the gainers, Samsung Electronics, even as it reported a 78% plunge in third quarter profit. That figure, though, beat estimates, raising hopes the chip market is showing signs of recovery. Meanwhile, over in Tokyo, shares of Uniqlo operator Fast Retailing rose 2% on expectations the company will blow past last year's record profit when it reports third-quarter earnings on Thursday. Here at home, Philippine shares underperformed, with the main index shedding nearly a fifth of a percent.
I think what the market is really focusing on right now is gauging the potential outcome of the U.S. inflation data due out tomorrow rather than the ongoing conflicts. Since what the market has realized, as we have seen in its movement yesterday, is that the conflict may remain confined within the two parties, Israel and Hamas. And since Israel is an oil importer itself, impact is likely to be minimal on oil prices. In fact, after oil prices surged last Monday, price didn't move dramatically. At $6,400, the market is poised to succumb to profit-taking. Our key or critical support that we are seeing right now still remains at 6,000 level.
Okay.
However, if we do see a significantly cooler than expected U.S. inflation, which I doubt, then that could be a case in which the PSEI may briefly reach that 6,400 level.
Philippine Central Bank Chief Eli Remolona says a 25 basis point hike is still possible as inflation risks linger. Remolona says the BSP in particular is monitoring the impact of the recent provisional fare hike. National Economic and Development Authority Secretary Arsenio Balisacan had warned another round of interest rate hikes could hurt consumers and the economy. But Remolona says the Monetary Board's decision would be based on data.
We are considering hikes, yes, but we're going where the data lead us. I don't think RC's views and our views are that far apart. I think what RC really meant was we shouldn't go for very aggressive hikes, but I wouldn't rule out 25 basis points, for example. Tightening has relieved pressure from the demand side. So far, we think it hasn't really affected our growth prospects. We're watching that very carefully.
Remolona adds the bank is also monitoring the possible spillover effects from the Israel-Hamas war on global crude prices. The BSP has kept its benchmark rates unchanged at 6.25% for four straight meetings. The Monetary Board will next meet on November 16 for their second to the last rate-setting meeting for the year.